Really, as a Democrat from California, thank you for joining me. You are well known for voting against the authorization to use military force. The president did talk about his posture in war. He said he doesn't want to kill hundreds of thousands of people in Afghanistan. What did you make about what he said about the use of the American military?
Well, I don't believe anything this president says. And so he says one thing one day and the next something else the next day. So it's almost like you can't believe what he says. You have to show me first before I can believe it.
I think this gets to what I want to ask you the most. What was the feeling on the Democratic side? I was watching you, and at the beginning I kind of saw faces holding back, and then I started to hear a rumble. Then with the prescription drugs issue, Democrats were shouting HR 3. I heard Democrats be more vocal than I have before in a State of the Union. What did it feel like? Why do you think that was happening? What does it mean?
For me, it felt surreal. It was quite disgusting. When he said one thing, and we know good and well, we, for instance, on HR 3, reducing the cost of prescription drugs, which he campaigned on, we passed a bill to do just that. Mitch McConnell won't even take it up. He won't even send it to his desk. And if he did, would he sign it? Who knows? And so once again, I think what, at least for me personally, it was quite frankly a sad night to listen to the commander-in-chief perform as if he's an actor in a production. It was quite surreal.
What did you make? There were two sort of TV moments where Rush Limbaugh was given the Congressional Medal of Freedom, woman was reunited with her husband.
And then one of the most insulting parts, I think there were four African Americans he pointed out. It was like, okay, come on, what's this about? You know, Tim Scott, you know, he talked about Opportunity Zone, the little girl that he had stand, who was a guest with regard to the opportunity scholarships, the homeless man who now started a business and others.
Didn't feel that was sincere?
No, I felt that was insulting, it was demeaning, and he was using them.
Last question, impeachment. The vote is tomorrow in the Senate. You voted for impeachment in the House. Is that at all hovering over this chamber tonight or no?
Well, I think we know, unless he says something that would change Republicans' minds, how the vote will go. But I have to tell you, it just confirmed once again that this man should be convicted and put out of office.
Should he be censured?
He should be convicted. There should be a fair trial. He should be convicted. He was impeached, so at least he is an impeached president. But I think given the crimes that he has committed, given the obstruction of justice, given the fact that he has totally ignored the legislative branch. We have three branches of government, and he has totally abdicated all of the principles of democracy. He thinks this is a dictatorship, so he should be tried and convicted.
Thank you, Congresswoman Barbara Lee. We appreciate it.
Republican Senator Mike Rounds of South Dakota. Senator, given what has been going on the last few weeks with the impeachment trial in the Senate, given everything else, what was the main message you took tonight from the president?
Well, first of all, we were happy that he was energetic, that he first of all started by talking about the things that we've done right so far. Very low unemployment, the best unemployment in 50 years, 7 million new jobs, the tax act that was passed, the fact that our economy is going, new trade deals and so forth. But then he also interspersed that with some very emotional times, talking about real people with real challenges and recognizing individuals who have done good things for our country. And then he ended with talking about the future. And I think that's what we were hoping to hear the president talk about, was not only what we've accomplished so far, but then to go on and say, but there's more to be done and there's more opportunities out there and there's good things to be done. And, you know, he talked about legal immigration. And then he also talked about our future. And he talked about making changes in healthcare. Prescription drugs, he wants to see something done on that. And I think in the United States Senate, there's a real move there. He talks about getting rid of surprise billing on medical medical charges. That's a positive thing. Republicans and Democrats get along. And if you notice tonight, one of the biggest cheers when we started talking about fixing our infrastructure. The president's made that an issue that he's wanted to do. And that was Republican and Democrats both. And so I think once we take care of the impeachment issues tomorrow, and that will be done tomorrow, I think most people in the country really want to see us get back down and focus on those challenges that our entire country has.
Senator, just quickly, I'm sure you know that Democrats are saying some of what the president said tonight belies where his policy has been. For example, the administration is in the court basically trying to undo the health care law that was passed under President Obama that would protect pre-existing conditions. Democrats also point out that this is a president who has not come to the table and tried to reach an agreement on reducing the cost of prescription drugs. So to what extent should we be holding him and his administration accountable for what's actually happening?
I can tell you that within our conference, we want to keep pre-existing conditions covered. But also, even before Obamacare came in places like South Dakota, once you were insured, pre-existing conditions were never an issue after that. And so there are a lot of us that understand that we don't want to have pre-existing conditions be a problem in the future. And in fact, the Alexander Murray proposal, which we were supporting, would actually have reduced the cost, and it would have kept pre-existing conditions at bay. Mm-hmm. So there have been options made available to us out in the past that I think the president would like to see brought in again. As a matter of fact, one of the items when it came to the proposal of the, what we call the Alexander Murray proposal in the Senate, was the fact that if Obamacare is identified as not being valid anymore, it will push people to come together to actually create a product that is affordable. And I think that's where the president is going.
Senator Mike Rounds of South Dakota, thank you so much for making time to talk with us. We appreciate it.
Thank you.